the visiting Boston Celtics.
Robinson for three. They grab their own miss.
Randall kicks to Hart. Pass to Brunson. Fires the three. Bangs home the trifecta. Brunson's got six.
Chandler Brunson's such three-point shooting here out of the game. That makes it four makes already from long distance.
Now Barrett pushing it up, and no one back to stop him. And again, New York with a triple.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic. It was a big part of why Knicks been able to get 17.
Seven outside. Robinson pulls it in. For New York, they've gone 6 of 8 in the game so far. Very solid start for them. Randall from outside. And again, New York with a triple.
And you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray. Seven.
Here's Porzingis. Boston, no good that time either.
That's pretty much the only way to keep him from taking advantage of you down low. You've got to play tough, physical defense.
Celtics trail by 13. Here's Tatum. Shot to stop the run. Brown. And it's Brown on the follow.
Brown.
He has 7. We're about 3 minutes into this first period.
2 minutes remaining in the first.
Randall kicks to Barrett. Back to Randall. A three ball. That one falls. His second basket of the game. He's now 2 for 3.
Julius Randle built up this lead.
Knicks leads. Well, a lot of importance placed on outside shooting. And tonight you can see why after that kind of quarter exploding from the perimeter.
And Greg, the way the Celtics have approached this season in terms of intensity, I think they clearly feel, though, they have unfinished business.
They've been so close to a title for a couple of years.
Checked in for the Knicks. Quickly comes in for Josh Hart. Luke Kornet, he's checked in for the Celtics. White comes in for Jason Tatum. Brown with the bucket.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash mouth physical basketball, guys.
Pass to Brunson. From outside the arc. Kept alive by New York. And the shot is good.
Julius
has had his third basket of the night right there.
They hold the early advantage. 13 on the glass.
Upside, Brown. No good there, and that would have cut it to single digits. Passes it to Quickley. Back to Barrett. It's a nice passing by New York here. On deep, Brunson. Rebound by Holiday. And so, it's Holiday with it. He'll bring it up for Boston. Down by 12. From outside, off the mark. Holiday's gone. 1 of 3 shooting so far.
New York foul. Jalen Brunson. First personal foul.
This is his first free throw of the game.
Jalen Brunson.
And the first one at the line. When you look at this Knicks roster, Greg, this is a team that feels it can make a deep playoff push.
And they have their stars. They have tons of young talent. Developing that talent and adding the piece or two should get them where they want to go.
And Barrett gets it to go.
They wasted no time stealing back to their offense.
Knicks so it's trail by 15.
15.
Good stolen by Barrett. And it goes down 2 points. Barrett's got 8 points.
Knicks lead. On the offensive glass.
Out against Barrett. So it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here.
Ball. Now into the lineup for your New York Knicks. Quentin Grimes.
There's 10 seconds left for the first quarter. Brown outside. Got a piece of it. And he gets it back. Next lead by 15.
30.
And back with the start of the second quarter
15.
In just a moment.
So
far through one quarter. It's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in a second. All right, we'll take a look now at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for New York.
We've got a bunch of this game yet to be played, but they're shooting it well from the three-point line. That's got to be a welcome sight.
They've done a great job tonight of getting out in transition, so that focus on fast break, that'll add to your total in a hurry.
Hart is out there with Julius Randle. Then there's Emmanuel Quickly, and it's Grimes in at the shooting guard position. There the Chris Rose will start the second. Getting the latest now from our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David, it's all yours. Take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. New York City remains a basketball mecca. The NYC legend and former Nick Mark Jackson always talks about the basketball environment. He says, coming up in New York, it's all about the 17 grind, the edge, the competitiveness, the swag, the confidence, the struggle, and the embracing of the bright lights. Kevin?
Well, it's all there, and it is the biggest stage for sure. David, thanks. Here's Randle, and again, it's Julius Randle. Right, you look at the size of some of these point guards now. Magic Johnson would feel right at home.
Yeah, it's a part of a larger trend with all the switching defensively. If you have just one smaller guy on the floor, he is going to get targeted.
Here's Sims. Yep, that one goes in there. Sims has got his first points of the night.
The assist totals are they're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Now here's White. 11 point game is left out. And here's Brown outside. And it's Grimes with the rebound.
Well, we're chipping some orange paint off the rim here, guys. You must be more patient on offense and trying to find ways to penetrate inside and get closer to the rim.
2 points. Randle's got four this quarter.
So active and understanding more and more with his experience where to be to get offensive rebounds as Julius Randle.
They get it again. New York leading by 18. Here's Sims. And the basket is good. He's got a chance here. 1 point to one.
Feels like Christmas right now. Just get trapped.
The Knicks making this run here. Brunson's checked in. Then for the Celtics, Hauser's checked in. And it's Pritchard in for Brown. You know, Greg, many in Boston question the wisdom of the smart Porzingis trade. What'd you think of the move?
I mean, aren't they given age and injuries in their front court? The trade makes sense, right? Also, they got some draft capital. But the ultimate test of this trade will be in the playoffs. The ring is the thing.
Snatched up. White. That's basket number two with his third shot off to a fast 2-for-3.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Randle finds Brunson. That's in. Coming off misses for Randle. And it's 9 points in for Jalen Brunson.
The sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
Jared Coming good.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Rebounded by Hauser. Celtics trail by 18. Tatum wide open, fires one. Great look, but off the mark.
Well, he loved to make them pay for giving up that wide open jumper. Just unable to do so.
And it's quickly missing. For Boston, they've gone 6-12 in the second quarter, right at the 50% mark from the field. Pritchard passes to Hauser. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's 1-for-2.
And you're going to take as many of those high-percentage shots as you can get.
Here's Sims. It's rebounded by Porzingis. Porzingis has got his fifth rebound in this one. Down low. Here's Hart. A good finish at the rack with the swift feet. Hart's got 8 points.
Well, defense making it difficult for Hart, but he stays tough and gets his shot.
Here's Tatum. And the rebound goes to the Knicks.
Oh, can't punish the defense for leaving him open that time. That's a frustrating miss for a really steady jump shot.
On deep, Brunson. That's in. That's his fourth basket of the night. He's taken 7 shots, a solid 50 shot.
And aren't we here with Brunson? This is what we
Here's
Pritchard. The pass to Porzingis. That shot off.
Hard against Tatum. Angle from outside. The offensive rebound. Great positioning on the putback.
A little bit of time, but now he's taking the pen off the cap. Why are you putting his mark on this game?
And here's Tatum. He'll bring it up for Boston. 6 seconds separate the shot game clocks. Pass to Pritchard to end the run. Good, and it's Tatum picking up the assist. Tatum's got his third assist on the night. 17 seconds left here in the second. Three-pointer landed. And Boston with the rebound. Porzingis has got 6 rebounds here tonight.
Well, after getting off to a great start, hitting those first two shots,
Pritchard.
He's definitely regressed a little bit in this quarter.
Hart with it.
That's got to be frustrating for the defense, too.
Just give up momentum like that at the end of the quarter. And for the first half, a pretty lopsided Celtics, it's the Knicks delivering the blowout. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks a lot. Here with Tom Thibodeau. Coach, what has gone well for your team in the first half?
Started making plays, you know, play unselfishly, force the defense to shift, attack, get downhill, then make a play.
You guys followed the instructions to the letter. Thanks, Coach. Back to you guys.
Thanks so much, David. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after this break.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Kenny, and a favorite time of the year as we're halfway through one of the first games of this fresh NBA season. New York came out ready to play. They showed tremendous effort and drove the action early, starting off with a 9-2 run. And they were rolling in that first quarter, up by 15 at the end of it. Then in quarter number two, they actually increased their intensity to pull further out in front, finishing with a double-digit advantage at the half. And let's get your thoughts, Kenny, on the Knicks.
Well, they've been incredible from beyond the arc. They're scoring the three in bunches, sinking them at a high rate. If the defense continues to allow them to do that, I'll keep saying, fire, fire!
And over to Shaq now. Your take on the Celtics.
First of all, where's the intensity? My team is punking me like this. At least try to put a stop to it. Nope. Keep giving up open looks. Let the lead get bigger and bigger and bigger.
And that'll about do it as we get ready for the second half. Let's take you down to Kevin Harlan.
Shout out to my man Joel.
Joel, what up?
Second half of basketball for you. You think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. You know, Jalen Brunson has been exceptional here, guys. Wow!
Yeah, and through the first two quarters, he has been the offense for this team.
Yeah, he's shouldering the load right now and looking really comfortable while he's doing it.
There wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. Celtics trail by 21. Starting off the second half, here's Joe Mazzulla's five. Horford and Porzingis are hanging in the post position. White is out there with Holiday, and it's Tatum in a good three. And for a team in the NBA's biggest market, amazing that it's been 5+ decades since the Knicks last night.
Close a couple times, but that has not been in recent history, Kevin, as you know. We've had a lot of great players, but man, it just shows you how hard it is to win in this league.
Now, Brunson, following Drew Holiday's three-point attempt. Now, the fast break, Tatum with the ball, and Drew Holiday, a bucket on the assist by Tatum.
3-point goal.
Tatum's got 4 assists now tonight.
Boy, does that help. Drew Holiday's connecting from the three-point line. line. It opens up so much of the floor.
Now, here's Holmes. He's got 11. Sinks the triple.
Bottom line. Josh, if you have shooters on your team, you can space the floor.
Well, there's no doubt he's a legitimate threat from downtown, and he's demonstrating that in this game.
And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Alder.
Thank you, Kevin. You know, Jalen Brunson, for the NBA at least, is small in stature. And his footwork enables him to operate inside and out. He says, I've tried to make my game for what I had as versatile as possible. I've got to be crafty. I'm not jumping out of the chair. I'm not racing down the floor in 2 seconds. But I'm going to keep you off balance. Kevin?
I love his game. David, I know you do as well. Hey, thank you. Here's Sims. A putback and Robinson enjoying the game.
Would be displeased with that kind of energy and effort that Mitchell Robinson showed there.
The train. The shot by Holiday, no good. New York leading by 21. Two free throws coming up, and they're trying to shoot from
it.
It's on for Sikis.
How about this Mitchell Robinson kid? His work ethic inside. Impressive.
So dominant, Greg. Inside, he's got that reach, able to go up and bother shots. He also led the league in field goal percentage in just his second year, so he knows where it is he's going to eat. Don't be surprised if he does that again.
Wrong. It's rebounded by Hartenstein. The Knicks have gone 3-7 on field goal attempts here in the second half. And Barrett gets it to go.
And sometimes the simplest play is the best one. Vincenzo made it.
Boston Celtics gone 1-7 from downtown since halftime. Yep, it counts.
That's just tremendous scoring instinct. So fun to watch him work in the half court.
Robinson finds DiVincenzo. Off target from outside.
Yeah, and you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
There's Brown with the three. Good. And it's Tatum picking up the assist. Brown's got 12 points in the game.
This is what the team wants JB to do. Punish defenses that don't respect him from the corner.
And so Brown will bring it up for the Celtics. It's rebounded by Hartenstein. The Knicks leading by 21. A three for DiVincenzo. A rebound by the Celtics. Porzingis has got his eighth rebound here tonight. And Holiday throws it down.
A fearless drive from Drew Holiday straight at the defense with that dribble.
Pass to Brunson. Barrett with the ball. Brunson with three. It's rebounded by Porzingis. Porzingis has got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. And they've had a tough time scoring in the half court.
Credit the defense for making it hard. They've done a great job of disrupting the timing and spacing between their offense.
Well, I think the defense was just okay on that play. Mitchell Robinson better.
There's Brown with the three. Offensive rebound.
Always better to be lucky than good when it comes to offensive rebound. And unless you're as good as he is, then those tip-ins are all about skill.
Now, here's DiVincenzo. He has yet to score.
His shooting has been a little bit below par. You think about what this lead would look like if he was on.
And the passing by Tatum.
In perfect timing, this run is exactly what they needed, and it's right when they needed it. They couldn't afford to wait any longer.
And he's good on the three ball.
For the offensive end, he's making the defenders pay right now. Seven all of the mistakes they're making.
Tatum, no good.
Wouldn't surprise me to see him find his touch and still be a factor. Don't count them out yet.
Back to DiVincenzo. From deep. Can't hit that one. Celtics trail by 20. To the paint. Here's Porzingis. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
Porzingis.
Brown's got 3 assists tonight.
And all of a sudden, things finally coming together for them. The deficit's still large, but now not insurmountable.
Well, the run simply has given them a chance. Great work by
he's got it!
Yes!
The Knicks!
Oh, beats the buzzer way
talent. The Celtics fans are stunned.
And so it's New York riding a 15-point lead at the end of the quarter. They've got their field goal percentage to thank for that. They've been hot from all over the floor tonight. Back to the action in just a minute.
How about a look now at our assist of the game? Brought to you by State Farm.
And how about the big fella here showing us? He's got some point guard skill here with the tremendous setup.
Now the passing for the team becoming contagious, this time involving the big.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. Randall will step in at the four with Robinson as the center. Then it's Barrett. Then there's Dante DiVincenzo. And it's Grimes in at the two. So that's it on the four for the Knicks. Celtics trail by 18.
75. 57.
To the inside. White. And it's in. Basket number six for him thus far. He has only missed two shots from the floor.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working to get inside and getting good shots from close range.
That bucket in. DiVincenzo's got six in the point.
If you want to chase him off the three-point line, DiVincenzo is able to settle in that time.
For the three. Good on the triple.
Maker that we could point to tonight has been second chance points. They've been in there, they've had active hands, they've been in great position, they've been smart attacking the offensive glass.
Outside White. Porzingis gets a two. It's rebounded by New York.
Well, maybe not the best shot against that kind of defense, but he still has the ability to knock that kind of shot down.
Yes, it's good.
Knicks lead.
Just over a minute and a half play here in the fourth. Crowd wide open, 85. Boston again missing.
And they had some muscle coverage that turned into
RJ Barrett. Using some muscle there on the finish. I like seeing Barrett be active inside.
59.
On the wing, Holiday. Boston again missing.
All the energy is on the other side right now, and every miss just makes it worse.
Well, the other team is scorching hot, and they come down on this end and can't find a way to get the embers going.
Over in the corner, White. Can they get it? Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time.
3-point goal.
Holiday's got his fourth assist in this one. Here's Robinson. And that one drops for him.
Mitchell Robinson getting more and more comfortable with plays like this. Contact on it, still able to finish.
Side Holiday is rebounded by Barrett.
Well, that's not a shot he's ever going to pass up, and he should, despite the miss, no defender anywhere near him. I love the end of Barrett. Either size four. Can really make things happen with that leaping ability.
Boston's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. That one goes in.
You have to be impressed with the offensive production. They have got it firing on all cylinders.
I mean, this team is just dangerous. Right now, every shot that they're putting up feels like it's going in.
Check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates that are clearly on the same page.
Grimes passes to Robinson. Rebounded by the Celtics. Brown's got his fourth rebound in this one. Shot from 16. He gets it in there.
Wow, a bona fide superstar. The pull-up is a deadly shot for Brown.
Robinson kicks to Barrett. Shoots a three. Nailed from 3-point land. Barrett's got 5 points now in this quarter.
Well, and this has been their strategy throughout the fourth period. We'll see how it pans out.
It's one thing to have teams shoot a bunch of threes, but with this team being that hot defensively, you got to chase them away from anywhere near that line.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest, just a total obliteration. You can safely say our mission accomplished now for the Knicks.
It was a standout performance across the board.
I mean, it was like watching a cat play with a mouse. They were able to do more or less whatever they wanted.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year. And we watched one guy all night long. And look at the stats, just confirms what a dominant game he had. What a night tonight it was for R.J. Barrett.
It was the kind of game for him that all scorers dream of, where the basket seemed as wide as a barrel.
Brown against Barrett. They need this. Here's Gornett, and he goes in for the dunk.
And just scrapes and claws for that offensive rebound and doesn't take any chances there with the put.
G.A. strong work all around, and the rebound and the stuff ball. Wow.
And once they smell blood in the water, you can see the killer instinct take over.
Yeah, up until that point, a competitive game, but once they broke through that barrier, it was all them, complete control.
And I like the back and forth here, showing confidence from Rain.
It seems like they're going to find out who can make the deepest threes. Right now, it's a shootout.
And here's White. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. Back to Brown. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touch by Randall.
Yeah, you love the pressure he's putting on him. Almost had that steal.
Yeah, pestering right now, and that's going to pay some dividends. At some point, there's going to be a turnover.
15 seconds left in the fourth. Horford the pass to Cornett, and that one is stuffed right through.
That's from really as good as Horford. Any passing big that we have in the NBA. Horford is a guy who can run an offense as a big.
DiVincenzo, the bounce pass. Barrett, no good. So no problem for New York as they get the win. It was a total of two teams tonight. One of them was in total control, operating flawlessly. The other just looking for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go. And once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
Well, now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much, Julius. Now look, you're banging in the paint, but what do you see from your backcourt?
They do a great job of, you know, they obviously can score the ball, but getting us in the paint and running the offense very well and leading the team that way.
Well, they led you to a win tonight, Julius. Thank you for your time. Kevin?
Thank you, David. That concludes the first game of the NBA season. So for David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. See you later.